All right, everybody, welcome back. We are diving into something super interesting today. Have you heard of AI hallucinations?
I think most people have heard the term by now.
Yeah, it's kind of a buzzword these days.
It is definitely buzzy.
But do you think most people really know what it means?
That's a good question. I mean, it sounds kind of sci-fi, right?
Yeah, it does. Like robots seeing things that aren't there.
Exactly.
But it turns out AI hallucinations are actually a real thing, and they can have some pretty weird and even impactful consequences in the real world.
Absolutely, and that's why we're doing a deep dive today.
Right. We're going to explore AI hallucinations, what they are, why they matter to you, and we've got a really interesting case study to help us understand all of this.
Oh yeah, this one is a fascinating story.
But our source material for today is a YouTube video by John McElhenney.
Now, quick clarification here.
Yeah, this is important.
We're not talking about Rob McElhenney.
Of It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia fame.
Right. Different McElhenney.
Yeah, no relation. But this John McElhenney found himself in this really bizarre situation thanks to AI, and it's a perfect example of how AI hallucinations can happen.
Absolutely. It's almost like a case of mistaken identity.
But amplified by AI.
Exactly. AI on steroids. Yeah. So John's story basically starts with him getting mixed up with Rob McElhenney, the actor.
And it's all thanks to artificial intelligence.
Yeah.
Like specifically AI like ChatGPT.
Exactly. ChatGPT is a good example here. This kind of AI, what we call a large language model, learns by analyzing huge amounts of data.
And I mean, we're talking about a truly insane amount of information that's out there on the internet.
Oh yeah, it's mind-boggling.
Articles, websites, social media posts, the whole thing.
All of it.
So even with all that data, even the most sophisticated AI can't always understand all the nuances of human language and relationships.
It's tough, right? Like even for us humans, context is everything.
Totally.
And so sometimes AI ends up making connections that seem logical based on the data it's seen, but in reality, totally off base.
Yeah, so in John's case, AI started connecting him to Rob McElhenney and attributing Rob's work to John.
Because they have the same last name.
And AI just put two and two together and got five?
Classic hallucination.
It even said that John was a writer for It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia.
I mean, can you imagine getting credit for one of the funniest shows on TV?
Right. Talk about ego boost. But that's where things start to get a little bit concerning.
Yeah, the funny games kind of stop there.
Because it might seem funny at first, but what if AI starts spreading misinformation about you?
And it's not just like a silly thing.
It's not just about being a writer on a TV show. It could be about your job, your relationships, your beliefs, things that actually matter.
Absolutely. I mean, it could damage your reputation, make people think things about you that just aren't true.
And think about algorithms, the things that control so much of our lives these days.
Oh yeah, they're everywhere.
What if an algorithm makes a decision about you, a loan application, a job interview, even something like parole, based on false information generated by AI?
That's the scary part. It's not just theoretical anymore, it's happening.
Exactly, and that's why this is such a big deal. So we've got this problem, right? AI hallucinations can create this false information and spread it. So what do you do about it?
Right, so you'd think most people would want to, like, correct the record.
Set the AI straight.
Yeah, fight back against this AI-generated fiction.
But that's not what John did. And this is where the story gets even more interesting.
He leaned right in.
He totally did. Instead of trying to fight it, John decided to embrace the AI's version of reality. He created a whole website, McElhenneyBrothers.com.
I love this part.
It's dedicated to this entirely made-up AI-generated idea that he and Rob McElhenney are brothers and creative partners.
It's brilliant. He's taking this potentially harmful thing and turning it into art.
It is so creative. But it also makes you think, right?
It does. It really shows you how these AI hallucinations can kind of warp our sense of what's real.
Yeah.
It's like AI is creating these alternative realities that are so believable.
And they can blend so seamlessly with the actual truth.
It makes you wonder how much of what we see online or even believe about the world is actually shaped by these AI hallucinations without us even realizing it.
That's the big question, right?
Yeah.
And it's only going to get more complicated as AI gets more powerful and more integrated into our lives.
It will. I mean, think about it. We're already using AI for everything from searching the internet to getting medical diagnoses. What happens when those systems start hallucinating?
Okay, so that's the big question then. What can we do about it? How do we make sure that we're not just blindly accepting what AI tells us?
Well, there's a lot of smart people working on this problem.
Oh, I'm sure there is.
Researchers are trying to develop better ways to train AI, making it more sensitive to context, less prone to bias.
So kind of teaching AI to think more like a human?
In a way, yeah. Trying to help it understand all those subtle cues that we pick up on naturally.
Got it.
But honestly, I think the most important thing right now is for all of us to be more aware of this issue.
So you're saying even though AI can be incredibly powerful, we can't just blindly trust it.
Exactly. It's like any tool, right? It can be used for good or for bad. The key is to understand its limitations.
And to question what we see.
To be critical thinkers. To not just accept everything an algorithm spits out as the gospel truth.
That's a great point. So everyone listening, remember, AI hallucinations are a real thing. They can be funny, they can be unsettling, but most importantly, they have potential to affect us in very real ways.
And if you want to see this all play out in a really creative and thought-provoking way, go check out John McElhenney's YouTube video and his website, McElhenneyBrothers.com.
Yeah, it's a fun website to browse.
It's a great example of how we can turn these weird AI glitches into something positive. But it's also a reminder that in the age of AI, we need to be more skeptical than ever.
Absolutely. We got to use our brains, people.
That's the best defense against AI hallucinations.
That's it for today's deep dive.
See you next time.
Bye, everyone.